The Maldives, as seen by Sentinel-2. Made up of some 1,200 islands in the Indian Ocean, the nation hosts a rich marine ecosystem, provides a popular holiday destination, and is home to more than 500,000 people. But with most of the country barely above sea level, it could be lost forever. As the world warms due to climate change, water once locked in ice sheets is melting. 25 years of satellite data reveals that sea levels have not only risen, but the rate is increasing. Scientists predict this extra water, up to a metre by the end of the century, could put thousands of coastal communities, major cities, and hundreds of millions of people around the world, including in Europe, at risk. Equipped with a radar altimeter, Sentinel-6 will make the most accurate measurements yet of sea level. Seen here during final testing in Germany at the end of 2019, it'll provide an internationally agreed reference for all other satellite altimeter missions that measure the ocean surface. An identical second Sentinel-6 satellite will be launched in 5 years' time, giving scientists at least 10 years of continuous data.
Sea level is a very direct symptom of global warming. So it's very important to measure it accurately. And sea level increase is related to the melting of ice, of the poles. It's also related to the accumulation of heat in the oceans. So these two elements together make the product of Sentinel-6 very relevant for the society.
Sentinel-6 will map up to 95% of the world's oceans every 10 days. Taking continuous measurements of sea surface and wave height, as well as wind speed, the satellite will also provide vital safety information for shipping through marine and meteorological forecasts. A joint project between Europe and the United States, Sentinel-6 will operate alongside other Sentinel satellites as part of the Copernicus program.
Europe today really has a leadership in Earth observation, and it has the largest Earth observation program in the world with all the satellites which we are developing. There are three series. There is the Earth Explorers, which are the science missions, the Copernicus missions, the Sentinels, and the meteorological missions. And the totality of those missions, together with national missions in the various member states of ESA, are today the biggest Earth observation capacity in the world.
The Sentinel satellites are giving us a new view of how our planet is changing. Vital information for governments, local authorities, all of us to act on.